Cancer, it's me, Stormy, and here is your horoscope for November 2018. In Cancer, this is such a movable month. We've got planets changing place, switching direction, and not to mention the big ticket item that I am so pumped about is that we've got the North Node of Destiny moving into your sign. This happens only every 19 years, and this is gorgeous. This is why I get so excited about the North Node. Yes, we've got Jupiter changing sign this month. We've got Mercury going direct. We've got Venus coming, or we've got Mercury going retrograde. We've got Venus coming direct. All of those things are great and they're big and we're going to talk about them. But with the North Node of Destiny, wherever this placement is happening, you will fulfill whatever the destiny movement is. And for you, this is in the first house. So this is a coming out party for you. You will be more present. People will see you different. You will show up different. You will have a status change. These are the things that happen. That outward perception of you is going to take a big shift. And it's not the one that it's like, oh yeah, great job on the haircut. This is the one where people start to see you in a way that really defines you. This is a way you start to let people see you. These are the interactions you'll choose to have. I mean, it's just such a gorgeous placement because with the rest of these placements, you know, we could expand. We definitely could with Jupiter. All of these other things could happen, but I love the North Node of Destiny because everybody gets on board with wherever it's happening in their chart. So I'm so excited about that. Look for a separate video coming about that where I will probably be going on and on because I get really excited. So let's jump in and let's just get this broken down because there's a lot to talk about this month, okay? So first of all, on the 6th, we've got that North Node of Destiny moving into your sign, into the sign of Cancer. Now, while it's lighting up your sign over here, and the North Node is where we're growing, this is where we're going to grow into it. We're going to fulfill these destiny things, right? Now, that South Node is going to be over in Capricorn, along with Pluto, along with Saturn. All of those energies are hanging out over there. And the South Node is what we're trying to outgrow or detach from. So this is going to be about relationships for you. And I'm telling you what, Cancer, this is going to be a big old 18 months for you of detaching from some relationships, I think, from the past, maybe even some relationships that have been kind of in your present that just are not helping you fulfill your destiny anymore. And it will also make it very clear, I think, which relationships from the past will stay around because there's something significant about it, but you will be detaching in your relationship zone because in who you are and who you're developing to be, you're gonna see that there's no value anymore. So you really grow up in these two areas. It's gorgeous. Now, also on the 6th, we've got Uranus, who is retrograde. He's going to slide back up out of Taurus and into the sign of Aries until March of 2019. Now, this is giving a big old handful of love to your 10th house. So you're going to be going back over your identity at work. But here's the thing. Because Uranus is moving backwards, and he already did a lot of work here for the last 7 years, really think about how much your career has changed over the last 7 years, or your soul level calling, or even your reputation or status in the world. Have you gotten married? Have you gotten divorced, right? Did you change your status out in the world? Think about those changes over the last 7 years. So as Uranus slides back this time, it's not so much about making those changes, but it's about breaking any bad habits you still have that would seek to keep those changes to your identity around when they're not needed anymore. And I think it's also a really nice place for you to, like, we have this big mountain in Colorado, and when you climb up it and you look down, like, because it is a climb, let me tell you, for real, your calves burn, your everything burns, but you turn around and you look around and you see how much progress you made and you're like, heck yeah, man. You know, so this could be something that you're doing as well, looking at the space of what you're doing right. What are you doing now that's working to take you forward? So that's going to be a beautiful energy, but please keep in mind, if you have still got some old habits or old behaviors, this is a time over this next few months where it's going to be breaking those down. Uranus comes to break down these structures because they don't work anymore, okay? Now, the 7th, we've got a new moon happening in Scorpio. So at the new moon, we're going to plant these seeds of intention for what we want going forward. I think this is a great new moon to have at a time where the North Node's just moved into your sign. Right here at this new moon, it's a fresh new start. It's intention. intense, it's intimate, and it's in your fifth house. This is the house of expression. Are you in a place now where you're saying what you want, you're saying what you need, and it's not about saying, I want you to respect me, but then you've done nothing to be respected about, right? It's not this place about like, value me, and you're not doing esteemable things. This is a thing where you are conscious and aware of what makes you you, what makes you joyful, and you're bringing it out, you're sharing it with the world, and that is bringing attention. That is bringing the demand for respect, right? This is also a beautiful place for new romance. If you're in a new romance, how amazing. You can have a fresh start right here. And it's a nice intimate bonding with this Scorpio energy here, I think, as well. This could be a beautiful fresh start for children. Are you at a place in your life where maybe children are on the table, or you've already got children and they're having a fresh new start that's got you excited or that's got you interested, right? Whatever it is, the fifth house is a very abundant, joyful, connecting, conception, new beginning house. New beginnings. You could be beginning something new. Yes, you could be getting pregnant. So if that's a thing you don't want to do, make sure you're doing what you need to do to not do that, okay? But this could also be maybe a new business or a new concept or a new hobby. Something, whatever it is, you're going to take a risk while you're doing it. And the risk is what makes it worth it, okay? On the 8th, we've got Jupiter moving into Sagittarius, and this is big news. I don't want to downplay it at all, but you've got the North Node moving into your sign, so I'm a little bit more excited about that. But Jupiter will be moving into Sagittarius into your 6th house, and now your 6th house this month starts to be busy. With Jupiter in Sagittarius, he's home, he's comfortable, he likes being in Sagittarius, so the energy is going to be strong, resourceful, and abundant, okay? Now, one of the things that happens when Jupiter moves here is Jupiter wants to expand you, but he doesn't just want to expand you in your head, he wants you to expand out into the world. He says, take an open mind and go out there and let's do stuff, right? Now, Jupiter being the planet of wisdom, how do you gain wisdom? Through experience, right? So you'll be bringing some experience to the table for sure around your career, around your health, around your mental health and wellness. This is very important, right? Also around coworkers or employees, freelance work, you're bringing some of that to the table. But I promise you, in the open-mindedness of Jupiter, you will also have some tough times because we learn and we grasp that wisdom through experience of what not to do. Usually. Okay, so there could be some hard times here as well, and I don't want to give you any delusion that it's just going to be easy. It's not, but Jupiter is working here to try and help you broaden your horizons, get bigger than you thought that you could, look at things from a different perspective, look at your coworkers from a different perspective than you ever thought that you would, okay? On the 15th, we've got Mars moving into Pisces, lighting up your 9th house space. Now, Mars in Pisces, this is a hard energy. Mars wants to go. He wants to do stuff, and he wants to do it fast, and he wants to do it hard, right? And Pisces energy is like running really fast through water. So basically, Mars is running in place. Where this is beautiful for you, even though Mars is a little uncomfortable, is that it slows you down. So in this 9th house space, which is foreign travel, foreign languages, foreign people, international things, publishing, broadcasting, podcasting, YouTubing, education, philosophy, religion, legal things, this energy is to slow you down here so that you're moving intentionally. Now, in these areas, this could feel a little bit blurry. Remember, Mars is desire. He is action. He is movement. And Pisces is that water energy, which makes it so it's a little bit hard to see exactly what you want or how to get there. So in your slowdown, what I would tell you to do is be reflective, right? Pisces is a reflective energy. Reflect on what you want in this area. Or it could also be too for some of you. Maybe you're traveling in some way. What I see is that it's traveling. It's you and another person or you in a business and you're on two separate places. And so there's a little bit of disconnect maybe in conversation or in action. There could be a disconnection in your sex life because one of you is someplace else. Either way, that energy will move on, but Mars and Pisces definitely makes that possible. Now, on the 16th, we have got two things happening. Venus is going to come out of retrograde, hallelujah. Okay, it's happening in your fourth house, so it's going to be coming out in the sign of Libra. So in the fourth house, some core level foundational things that you have come to understand. What do you keep? What do you get rid of? right? The things you've decided to keep, you're going to be prepared to take action on and put into focus in your life. And this is very important. You're a natural fourth house sign. So having that solid foundation where it's not ruled solely by emotions, especially in your partnerships, Libra, right, is really critical. So I think that this energy helps you see how to actually make a home, an inner home in your relationships, not just your romantic relationships, but in your relationships, right? There's a lot of this thought process of outgrowing some things from the past. And I think that this Venus coming direct helps you see that. And I think we start to see that play out in your life. Maybe you're actually making a nice solid home now. Now, of course, Venus is coming direct in the fourth house. You could be making renovations. You could be moving. It could be the time where you are relocating for some way, shape, or form, or redecorating your home, right? Venus is like, ooh, I'm direct. I really think we need to change that wall color. That could definitely be something that's on the agenda. Now, on the same day, Mercury is going to be going direct. So Mercury is going to be going direct in that sixth house. Now, I told you the sixth house is busy. So with Mercury, who is our communication planet, decision-making, thinking, patterning, right, strategy, discernment, it's going to be backwards. So you may be re-looking over some things in your sixth house space, health, daily routine, mental wellness, body wellness, co-workers, work itself, right? These are all things, service. These are all things that you could be looking over. I'm getting the indication to definitely small animals. If you have small animals or puppies or kittens or something like that, something could be going on with them. You have to re-communicate about something or re-strategize, right? But either way, what Mercury's going to ask us to do in this sixth house is to re-edit, reconnect, revisit, revise. You're going back over the things that are happening in this house, okay? Now keep in mind, and I think this is super important, when we have got a Mercury retrograde, everybody is in a Mercury retrograde. So there's nobody who's just out there being not Mercury retrograde, okay? So be graceful with people. Try to grant people some grace. We're all trying to figure things out and we're flipped in a different direction, right? Even if you have Mercury retrograde natally, you're probably going to be in a little bit of shock as well because you're like, uh-oh, where did this whole outside world come from, right? Instead of just being your normal internal world. So grace is the slack the universe cuts us for being jerks. So try and have some grace and some patience with people, okay? Now, as we get to the 22nd, the sun now enters into Sagittarius. So you're very busy defining, starting to define now who you are and who you're going to be in this business space, because where the sun is at, it's lighting it up. You want to be seen. You want to be known here. Maybe this is promotion energy for you, right? It's going over your accomplishments at work. It's going over that gym time. Have you made gains? Have you lost, right? Whatever it is, you want to be seen. You want to be known, and there's going to be high focus on the sixth house area here. And I also am wondering too, I just feel like there's this space for you here where you may be venturing, maybe it's a culture because this is Sagittarius, so it's foreign or travel. Maybe you're venturing into a place where people have a different belief system than you, or maybe your coworker has a different belief system than you, or something like that. And it's opening your mind. It's an open mind. And maybe you're going back to a place that you used to go, or that you've been to before, that you've traveled to before, or something like that. But it's very much so, there's seems to be some philosophy or different philosophies involved here as well. So whoever that's for, let me know. All right, on the 23rd, we've got a full moon happening in Gemini, so in your 12th house. Now, a full moon in the 12th house, the 12th house is, first of all, very transitional, but the full moon says something has to be ended, acknowledged, or adjusted, so we're going to shift here, right? So because it's in Gemini, the very first thing that came to me is maybe you will be ending, acknowledging, or adjusting conversation with someone from the past. Cancer, you could be putting it to bed here, or you could be moving it into a stage of your life where it's just not really a thing right now. right? So that's a very interesting energy for me. Now, if you are studying, you're a student or something like that, or you've been having conversations with someone that, you know, it's maybe been a little bit more low key. It doesn't mean it's romantic. It could be romantic, but something like that, the conversation or the information could be adjusting or coming to light. But something is certainly ending here in this 12th house space. Now, Gemini, I also acknowledge as the first mental sign that we have. So I just feel like you're cleaning out some mental cobwebs here. Some things gotta go, and you're ending them. You're letting them go. They've risen to the surface during the retrograde energy, especially of Venus, which is your values. And you're like, I don't need that anymore. I can't run forward with that anymore. So a lot of space spiritually is made for you. A lot of energetic space is made for you with this full moon. Now, as we end the month on the 24th, we've got Neptune coming direct. Hi, Neptune. And it's going to be in your ninth house over there in Pisces. Okay, so here's the thing. When Neptune is retrograde, things feel like it's like you have this dream, but you can't figure out how to make it reality, right? It's like it can't land. And this has been happening since June. So at this point, with Neptune coming direct, the dream can become the reality. You can see the pathway of how to make that happen. It's not just this dream and this vision over here. You're like, yes, this is where it started, but here's how I make it concrete, right? And this is my analogy I always use with you guys. Before a chair was a chair, it was just a dream. It was just an imagination. It was just the vision. And then it became an actual thing. And now we've got 10 different thousand kinds of chairs, right? It starts somewhere. So if you've had the vision up here, beautiful down here, that it will become a reality. And of course, this being in the ninth house space, this is travel, this is publishing, this is broadcasting, this is foreign things, international things, religious things, right? I think in our societies as a whole, we're definitely going to see some things become reality. We're going to see some cultural things, some political things, some philosophical things become an even stronger reality. Now, with it being direct as well, the last thing I want to say about that is that you may be forgiving something or someone, or having compassion in this area. Let's just say, Cancer, that you're traveling or you're doing something foreign to you, and you are showing up with the utmost amount of compassion here, which I think is absolutely divine. Mars has slowed you down enough now. Neptune has brought the lights on, and you're able to show up with a level of creativity and compassion that you maybe weren't interacting with this energy before. So I think it's going to be a great month. I can't wait to talk about the next 18 months of the North Node being in Cancer. It's your sign. I cannot wait to talk about that with you and through the year as well. So like this video, comment, share, subscribe, and I will see you in the next video, okay? I love you guys. Bye.